Hey there, everybody, this is Millennium Jester signing back in with Let's Play Final Fantasy. Last time we were here at I don't know. But anyway, here we have a new little mechanic to this game. A new little irritating mechanic to this game. And no, I'm not talking about the poison scorpions, those guys are jerks. Anyway, the new mechanic is the fire tiles. The fire tiles will do damage to you, but while you're on them, you don't run into enemy encounters. So, I mean, it's a win-win. It's kind of like poison in Pokemon, you just kind of take it. You just kind of sit there and freaking just suck it. Actually, we're still in good health. Yeah, it doesn't take a lot of health from you. So you can, like, walk in there forever, so. Anyway, we're going to go up here. Oh man, one Hill Gigas? I don't think we're ever going to win that fight. Alright, so basically, this area right here is a treasure chest grab. You can grab whatever treasures you want. Fight fire elementals to your heart's content. I mean, have Lori gain a level. That's the dream right there. I believe we already have Mithril armor for all the characters that I need to have it. Alright, let's just quickly go through these. Alright, okay, cool. I was wondering if we were in one of those areas where it's just like an encounter every step. I was going to lose my mind and eventually kill everybody. But no, we'll save that for Sweeps Week. Because, you know, YouTube has Sweeps Week. Damn. Yeah, it's really easy. You're not going to run into anything too completely banana sandwiches in terms of random enemies right here. And we get the Greatsword. I'm going to give that to Jester here. It's like the Great Axe, but it's effective against giants, and that helps a lot. Also, I believe it gives you more hits. I could be wrong. Does the Great Axe do that too? No, it's just a large axe made for battle. It's only a 4 difference. I think it's a little bit stronger than the Mithril Sword. Or maybe it's the same strength. I could be wrong. I don't know. 4,150 gil, oh my, but Jesus. Bam. Nothing like a super fast battle to get your heart in the game. Oh yeah, Grey Oozes, these jerks. They're alright. I've seen worse. Fire Hydra, hit these guys in the face. Oh Jesus, man. They're not playing around. Luckily, Dr. Zai likes to just fucking... Oh, man. Need to bleep that out. Gotta throw in a Pikachu sound again. That's gonna require a bit of editing that I don't have the skill for. Anyway, here we enter the Hall of Freaking Treasure. Look at all this. Bam, tent. Bam, Mithril Helm. Not that we need another one of those. Bam, Mithril Gloves. I guess I didn't really need to buy the gloves earlier. Alright, so let's heal up a little bit. Just to make sure that I'm going to make it through this. Wonder if it's more cost effective to use Kiraga. Probably not. Alright, let's do that. Oh, come on. Lava Worm. That doesn't sound good. Bam! 8 hits. Lava Worm is let's see if he survives one more round. I'm gonna try using Blizzard on him. No, he's... Like I said, the enemies here aren't too banana sandwich that you actually need to, like, really think about what you're doing. God, just ridiculous amounts of stuff. Phoenix down? Oh, glitches. Glitches with old man snitches. Alright, let's do my favorite part, the backtracking. So what kind of Final Fantasy game would this be without copious amounts of backtracking through hordes of enemies? Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to cut this part out right here. I'll meet you guys back at the stairs. Isn't that some sweet music? Alright, so now that we're out of here, make a mad dash for it! Now, there is an enemy that I would warn against fighting. They're called Pyrolisk. They're like the Cockatrice. I hate that enemy. Oh, I hate it, something fierce. That thing is just a jerk. sandwich. And, like, I don't know if you've ever had a jerk sandwich, but it's not good. It's no bueno. Alright, so we're gonna head right here. Yeah, see, these guys, not too bad. As long as you keep your head on straight, you can get rid of them. Alright, so here we go. Let's heal up a little bit. Kira. Yeah, Kira's gonna do it, mostly. Yeah, I believe it's like 10 MP. Alright, so let's see where we're at now. We gotta make another mad dash for it. This game is all about the mad dashes. Luckily, there's like no enemies on this floor. You can just avoid them all. Go straight down. And, like, it seriously doesn't take like any health. I think they changed it from like the original game, because I feel like it did more damage in the original game. Alright, let me think here for a second the best way to get through here. Yeah, I'm going the quickest route, by the way. I'm not doing any of this game where we're gonna try to figure it out by ear. No. No. This area sucks. Like, a lot. This is honestly, like, it's honestly one of the harder dungeons. I'm not gonna lie. Alright, so let's give a good old-fashioned family blizzard. Shink! So you did some decent damage there. Yeah, we can get by a lot quicker if we do that. Oh god. Or we could just find another one. So we get a gold needle. What's in this chest? Is it a gold needle? What is this? Alright, let me think of where we need to go here. Sorry if I'm like pausing for bits. I'm trying to think of the best way to get through here. Alright, first things first, we're gonna go to the left. Cause on this floor... Oh damn. There are minotaurs! But then, Dr. Zai was just like, no. Drixie's like, no. It's not happening. He slapped that minotaur in the face with his fist. Alright, so we get the flame shield. Very nice for this temple. I keep calling them temples. I'm sorry if I do that. It's just a... I don't know. Ice brand. We get the 880, and we get that. So let's equip that ice brand. Oh, yeah. That's nice, isn't it? And we're also going to equip that flame shield. Shield alive with the power of fire. Fire! Believe it gives you fire protection. Could be wrong. I don't know. Alright, it's time. We're starting to dig deep here. We're gonna need all the healing we can get. I'm gonna have to go and use one of my ethers. Slap that. Let's slap it on Drixie. He needs it. For all those spells he's been casting lately. I swear, Drixie, man. I'm like, Drixie, you need to stop casting spells. He's like, I can't do it! I gotta keep going. Alright, so let's keep going. Let's follow with Drixie, keep going. Oh man. And fight lava worms, because that's what we do. 155 gil. 10 gil, yeah. You guys, I came into this dungeon, I was like, I hope I get 10 gil. At least 10 gil. I'm gonna be very upset if I get any less than that. So there's a second ice brand up here that we can just take. It can just be ours. Oh yeah, and that gold needle, I think, Oh no, I already got the ice brand, never mind. Yeah, you only get one. Yeah, it's one of those items that, like, if you, like, grab it in one, it's available in more than one spot, and if you grab it in one spot, it's not available in the other spot. Alright, so we could go down and to the right. And up there is, there's, like, a staff and some other stuff. I don't think we need that right now. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, it's kinda dumb. Lori's not gonna use it. Lori's gonna be on the knives. So we're probably gonna stick with just that. Or can the staff be used for something? I can't remember now. You know what? No, I am gonna grab it. We're already here, why not? You can see all the thought I'm putting into this right now. Die, monster! You don't belong in this world. So we get 1250. Fire lizard. We kill that in the face. We get a staff. Now, I wonder if the staff is... Because there's items in this game that can be used in battle. They have effects. a wooden set. No, it's a staff from the beginning of the game. Alright, that is not what I thought it was. So we're gonna ignore that. We're gonna run away. Oh god. Minotaurs. Don't you remember? Drixie loves Minotaurs. Alright, so on the right, there's a bunch of gold needles. So I'm gonna grab one of those, because gold needles are frankly awesome in this game. Oh god. It's one of these numbers, isn't it? Oh, a red dragon. Oh, damn. Alright, this seems new. Alright, so I'm gonna attack him with that. I'm gonna attack him with that. Attack him, and then we're gonna lay down some law right here. Some quick law. Bam! 91 damage. Aw, man. The enemies in this game continue to disappoint me. You have failed me for the last time. Alright, so we're gonna throw on that flame mail. If anything, it'll help Jester just take hits like a boss. I mean, he's already doing an admirable job. Like, I would give him a medal, like the hit-taking medal. But I already gave it to, I'm sure I gave it to somebody else. I don't know, watch my tactics playthrough. I'm sure I gave the hit-taking medal, I don't know, to somebody crazy. I already took the gold needle. What to do? Alright, so we're gonna go down here. Down into the left. But first, we're gonna punch things in the face, because they deserve it, frankly. And then we're gonna punch more things in the face, because they deserve it, frankly. And then we're gonna come down here, and this is where you fight Merilith! Wow! Awesome! Groovy! Alright, so we're gonna heal up before this fight. Should I keep it in this episode? Probably. I'm probably gonna keep it in this episode. We're gonna make this a long one, guys. Dig deep. Alright, so let's do this. So you are the ones who defeated the Fiend of Earth and roused Merilith from her slumber? Are you Merilith? Why are you talking about yourself in the third person? Yeah, it is Merilith. Why is she talking about herself in the third person? For boss time! Alright, Merilith is kinda crazy. She's got like 1,440 HP. Not weak to ice. So we're gonna lay some smack down here real quick. I'm gonna temper. Let's go with him, and then he is gonna do his thing. He's actually gonna temper him. We're gonna double temper. Get more tempers than anybody should have. Believe she can lay down some serious damage on your guys. I like the background for this fight. Alright, and then we're gonna go with what else do we got? Not Fokara. I thought there was another spell I could use to kinda like boof my guys, but I guess not. So we're just gonna lay down some attacks, and I'm gonna go with Scourge. Nah, no. It's not gonna work out here. Let's try Thundaga, see how that works out for us. Bam, look at that damage. Bam! Thundarga. 107 damage. Just like nothing. She's gonna hit our guys with some heat. Yeah, that didn't do anything. Alright, so we're gonna attack. Let's get Akira going on Lori here, because I don't think he could take another hit. And we're gonna do a... I do have a Faraga. Let's do... Actually, I'm gonna use an item. Let's use some high potions on him. He can bring me back up to speed. And she blinded Lori, which is gonna suck. Apparently not too bad. Lori just kinda accepted that into his soul. Alright, let's see what we got going on here. Do I have any, eye drops? There we go. No. You're gonna attack, you're going to eye drops. And you are going to... let's haste up Jester here. That was probably the other one I was thinking of. Bam. Jesus, Jester. Jesus. Making fiends disappear. And Drixie gained a level, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm surprised I was able to get this all done in one episode. Uh-oh. Oh, it always looks like it's gonna shatter. The way their little exclamation points appear above their heads. And now the Hellfire Chasm is open. Not that I went over there and showed you guys where that's at, but just in case I ever do, that's where it's at. That's what's happening right now. Not that I really want to go there right now. But that's about all the time we have for this episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy after we fight this Fire Gigas who's just chilling. So I'm going to see you guys next time on the magical adventure of Magical Girl Lolita. I don't know. Anyway, this has been MillenniumJester signing off. Have a nice day.